McIntyre.
Here, Sergeant.
Les Paul and Mary Ford.
Here, Sergeant.
All are present and accounted for, so let's go to town. Of your friends and neighbors in the National Guard is jammed in here to do some dancing and some listening. My name's Jim Collins, Sergeant J. Collins on drill nights, and it's my pleasant duty to introduce you to the leader of our National Guard Band of the Month, Hal McIntyre. Hal, I hope you and your boys are in top shape for the occasion.
As they say in the sports world, Sarge, we're really up for this one. We always are for the Guard.
Well, that's good news. And it's also my enjoyable duty to introduce our stars of the month, Les Paul and Mary Ford. You ready, Mary?
Well, my voice is ready. For the rest, you'll have to check with Les.
Well, the guitar strings are in good shape and the gadgets are all turned on, Sarge.
For the moment, you and Mary are what you might call our ready reserve. Because Hal McIntyre and the band opened the proceedings with Jeannie McManus and the McIntot singing Dry Bones.
Gather round me, little chillin', and listen to the word of the Lord. Give a lesson out of sinners, to a lesson from the word of the Lord.
Ezekiel cracked him, dry bones. Ezekiel cracked him, dry bones. Ezekiel cracked him, dry bones. Now hear the word of the Lord.
Ezekiel cracked him, dry bones. Ezekiel cracked him, dry bones. Ezekiel cracked him, dry bones. Now hear the word of the Lord.
Boys were up for this one, you knew what you were talking about. They were really fit and flying high.
Like one of your Air National Guard aviation cadets?
Say, that's a good point.
And that aviation cadet training is a good deal, too.
Another good point. As you say, the aviation cadet training a fella gets in the Air National Guard is a real good deal. And signing up for this top-notch pilot training is open to any unmarried man between 19 and 26 and a half who's physically fit and a high school graduate.
College degree not needed?
Not for aviation cadet training in the Air Guard. Now, you fellas between 19 and 26 and a half who qualify, take your training at regular Air Force schools. There's none better in the world. And you have the opportunity to win your wings and officer's rank, either as a pilot or observer. You train with jet, radar, all the newest equipment of the air age.
And with all the commercial airlines ordering jets right and left, aviation seems to be a particularly good career right now.
Get the facts at your local Air National Guard unit. The very fellas you'll fly with after your training's completed. You'll find in flying, like everywhere else, you get a good deal in the Guard.
Well, that certainly puts it right on the line, Sarge. Now, how about putting some of that Les Paul music on the line?
Right. And watch everybody gather around to watch while Les plays Magic Melody. Calls out Mary to join him on the stage of the Armory for a big favorite, Runnin' Wild.
I'm running wild, lost control. Running wild, mighty bold. Feeling gay and reckless too. Every time, all the time, never blue. Always going, don't know where. Always showing.
Talked for a long time about the great combination of Mary's voice and Les's guitar work.
Instead of discussing that, Sergeant, why not discuss another powerful combination I've heard you talk about before?
Oh, what's that?
I think my wife, in a subtle way, means the combination of a young fellow between 17 and 18 and a half, his education or job, military service, and the National Guard.
Oh, sure. And, of course, the two key words in that combination are National Guard. Because the perplexing problem of how a guy between 17 and 18 and a half, just starting college or a job or still in high school, can fulfill his military obligation becomes a cinch when he joins the National Guard. You see, in the Guard, you young fellas between 17 and 18 and a half can normally fulfill your military obligation with a minimum of interruption to your career or your education. In the National Guard, you can even conveniently arrange to work in your 6 months of active duty training without seriously affecting your schooling or your job. It's something to ask about at your local National Guard armory. When you learn the facts, you'll find out that you get a good deal in the Guard. Give me Hal McIntyre and his orchestra playing Give Me the Simple Life, and Who Needs More? Again for another gala gathering with dance music by our National Guard Band of the Month, Hal McIntyre and his orchestra.
When you start calling the roll next week, Sarge, we'll all be here. You can count on that.
Count on it, I will. And we'll all look forward to some more singing and special instrumental work by our stars of the month, Les Paul and Mary Ford.
I can promise you that Mary's going to sing a couple of real big favorites next week, Sarge.
And I can promise that Les will bring along his guitars.
That sounds great from where I stand. And all we need to make that party complete is a big crowd of you folks. So how about arranging to join us? This is Sergeant Jim Collins inviting you on behalf of my buddies, your friends and neighbors in the National Guard, who keep America strong by keeping their guard up. Les Paul and Mary Ford were brought to you through the courtesy of Listerine.
The National Guard is ready on the land.
Jim Collins suggesting you listen now for news of your local National Guard unit.